Hello guys, welcome back to my page and my YouTube channel. We are today July 9, 2014, and the topic discussion that we are going to do today is in regard to employment in Haiti. I've spoke about that particular topic, and it seems to have been very, very requested and demanding, and I've decided to do a second part in regards to being employed in Haiti. There is a lot that should be said in regards to that topic, but I'm just going to really elaborate the most important things about employment in Haiti. Basically, employment in Haiti is almost non-existent, as I told you. The majority of the people who work in Haiti who have a somewhat stable job work for a foreign agency. People who work, you know, so sometimes NGOs, a couple of people may get a few jobs at the U.S. embassy and you know, different type of embassy, Canadian embassy, Brazilian embassy, and it's just like the employment in Haiti, it's tough. Like I said before, it's almost non-existent, and the layers of the problems that we face when we come down to Haiti and we want to work is very enormous, because the first thing that you have to keep in mind is you are not going to get a per se a job on your studies in Haiti. It's because the employment is so rare, and if you only want to have a job in what you studied, then you're gonna be sitting down and not work. I don't have a degree in education, but I find that ever since I've been in Haiti, the area that I've worked most with has been in regards to education. Now, in Haiti, you have to be flexible. You have to be knowledgeable on different things, meaning if you're one person, so you went to school and you studied, and the only thing that you're knowledgeable on is what you earn your particular degree, I mean, 9 times out of 10, it's gonna be hard for you, because in Haiti you have to be flexible so that you can get different type of kind of job in different areas. That's really what's gonna keep you going, because the employment sector is so rare. You have to be able to tackle different things and put yourself in different areas so that you can, you know, get different kind of money income coming in. I've talked about the fact that you are not going to get paid at the rate that you could have got paid if you were living in the United States of America. That's the second thing. You know, if you earn a bachelor's degree, if you earn a master's degree, even if you earn a PhD degree, the reality is that you are not going to get the same pay. You know why? Because if you work with foreigners, if you work for an international agency, they know what's going on in Haiti. So they will never hire you when they can hire a local person for cheaper. You know, they're never gonna do something like that. You know, they're gonna be cost effective, and they're gonna tell you that they are investing, and they're gonna try to play a little game with you. They're gonna tell you that, oh, this position is for the local, it's not really for the international, so we can't really hire you. We really want to hire the people of Haiti. When the truth is the matter is they let's say that if it was for you, they could have paid you, let's say, $30 for an hour. They're not gonna pay you $30 an hour. So they'll hire a local and they'll give them like $6 an hour, not even all of that, and then they'll call it a day. So now, if you want the job and if you really want it, you have to negotiate with them, and you know, you have to be able to lower your price. Now, it's gonna depend on also that type of particular agency or particular employer, what they want done, because some people, if they want something done, but usually it's not a long term, let's say it's a contract, it's a shorter contract, and they really want to get it done, and they really want people who are knowledgeable, people who can get the work done, they will pay the price, they will hire you. But usually you're gonna find that it's a 6 to a year contract, it's not permanent. So those are people who are coming into Haiti, they have a project, they want the project to be successful, they want the project to be finished, so they will hire you, they will. So now it's like you have the competition. They don't have a problem to pay anyone, you know, they're not about that. they want the best person. So now you're just competing. You're competing with other international people who perhaps are looking at the job and they want to come down. So, and you're competing with people in Haiti because the Haitian people are extremely bright. They just don't have opportunities. But they are as bright, if not more, than people from the U.S. because they have to be creative to get certain type of work. So you're competing at all levels. So you get that. And then the other thing in regards to employment in Haiti is, like I said, being able to be flexible. Flexibility is really what's gonna keep your income coming. You gotta be able to tap into different doors. You gotta be able to tap into different resources in order to get the money. You gotta be able to work with this company. I'm working with this company. I'm working with this company at the same time. That's really, so it's like, let's say you're not working per se with one person, but you're working with different companies that can get your income. Excuse me, that can get you the same income for one thing. What I would recommend to you, I've said it in my previous video, I think that it would be a little bit better for you to get your employment from the US or Canada, wherever you're coming, and come down to Haiti instead of all be here in Haiti and trying to tap into these jobs. You understand? So get these jobs while you're already over there. So you're coming down with a job already. Because once you're here and you're trying to tap into them, it's different. It's a little different, you know. You have to look at it. It's a little bit different. So I would always recommend that you coming down with them having a job, and that's going to be better for you. Perhaps it's not going to be the best job, but what you have to put in your mind is, you know, if you're coming for the first time, what you have to put in your mind is you need the income. You know, you do need the money. So once you have the money, and when you have stashed a little bit of money, then you can proceed and you can do different things, you know, in different parts of the country. So, and employment in Haiti, you know, you guys know I work at the youth agency, and you guys know I do a lot of workshops. The number one thing that I face with the young people that I work with is their mentality, especially the young girls, like the young women, the mentalities behind them getting a job. Because what is the reality? The reality is that they already put them themselves that if they are a young girl, what they put themselves is that they have to sleep with the boss.